coming back for another video. If you do not know who I am, my name is Nicole. I'm the founder and editor-in-chief of Epifiana. It is a lifestyle magazine for women. We talk about career, travel. I interview a lot of different women, self-care, relationships. But here on YouTube, we do book reviews and beauty product reviews. Now, if you follow me on Instagram or Snapchat, you know that last week I was in Poland for a few days. It was a crazy, very quick trip to Europe. I went to the Google Developers Days in Krakow. It was a wonderful experience. I got a really discounted gift from Google, so thank you, Google. And it was just a great experience. I'll be writing some articles about the experience that'll be coming up on the magazine in a few weeks. For the month of September, we're just focusing on style and fashion, so that's why the articles are coming up right now. Now, while I was flying, I finished a book pretty much in 24 hours. I needed to occupy my time. I think two videos ago, I talked about that I was going to take this book with me. I wasn't 100% sure if I was going to finish it, but I did. It's called The Men in My Life. Now, it is a memoir by Patricia Bosworth. She is a contributing editor to Vanity Fair, but she started her career as a model, catalog model, and a theater actress, and then a movie actress in the 1950s. And so this book takes place during a snapshot of her life, pretty much focusing on the 50s and early 60s of her career. And it's called The Men in My Life because that's what it focuses on. It focuses on the relationships with the men in her life during that time. So her father, her brother, who unfortunately dies when she's in her 20s in a very tragic way. I'm not gonna say how, I want you to read it, but it was a very tragic death. And all her relationships, so her romantic relationships, whether with boyfriends, lovers, one night stands. And that was something that was another part of the story, was her growing into her own in her 20s as an actress, as an independent woman making her own money, you know, and being okay with her sexuality, her sexual desire, and just owning her body and worshiping her body. So, you know, if she wants to take on lovers, she can, and being okay with having sex with people that she doesn't want to start a relationship with. Now, she makes no, she does not hide the fact that she did grow up in a privileged lifestyle, if you will. Her father was a successful lawyer and her mother was an author. Both of their careers went up and down. So her childhood wasn't always rosy, and you know, her teenage years weren't great, and her, like, even her 20s weren't that great. However, they did give her a good financial and loving, like, foundation. So her life did start off pretty comfortably. She grew up in San Francisco, Aptos. Both her brother and her father are buried, I believe, in Sacramento. So I like the fact that the places she listed I know about, and I'm like, it's easy for me to relate to them, because I'm like, oh, I know those places. So she started her career again as a catalog model, and then she auditioned for the Actors Studio. The Actors Studio is just crazy, like, clubhouse, if you will, for the creative types. It's a place where actors, actresses do workshop after workshop, and they do maybe plays. Like, it's just to bring out the best raw talent out of these creative people. And to keep in mind, like, people that have been through the Actors Studio are Paul Newman, Marilyn Monroe, like, Hollywood icons. And she auditioned once and got it. And that was something she was very proud of, and I'm like, you should be proud of it, because, you know, it's a place where people audition 17, 20 times and don't get in. And during that time, all she really had was maybe a commercial to her name. She didn't do a lot of theater acting, and then all of a sudden she dived right into theater acting. I mean, but it wasn't like she was proud of always her work. She was always pushing herself to be better. She was always, like, taking notes. She was always trying to learn how to be a better actress. because she really, really wanted to be an actress. So that was something I really admired, was that she didn't state ever that, oh my god, I was amazing, like, since the get-go. No, like, she struggled, like any creative folks, to find her real, true, like, raw talent. So, yes. Now, a big part of this book, which I thoroughly enjoy, was that on one side, her life looks pretty rosy. Has two supportive parents. They love and support her career. I mean, they both have their own personal issues that she has to deal with. You know, and she's making her own money. She's going to a great university. Oh, by the way, she went to Sarah Lawrence University, which is a very prestigious college. And so she was doing that while modeling and acting. And so going to this great university, having this wonderful experience, so that's one side. But she got married to her first husband at a very young age, while she was still in college, and to this he was a struggling artist who, I mean, he wasn't an artist like she was an artist, where he wanted to better himself and learn the new art and all this new stuff, and like audition and do all these things. Like, he just wanted to paint in a dark studio and just somehow someone find out that he's such a great artist. But he was also an alcoholic and really abusive and just had a really bad temper. So on one hand, she's this independent woman, but on the other hand, she's like this wife who is being abused and has to make dinner and wash clothes. So it just reminds you that women live such dual lifestyles, especially during the time she was in her early 20s during this horrible marriage, and when you're trying to figure out who you are. And some people are there to help you learn and grow who you are, and some people are there to take advantage of your weakness during that time. And he was definitely one of those people that took advantage of that weakness. I mean, she looks at the bright side and see that relationship really did teach her some life lessons, so I'm glad that she took some life lessons from that. But yeah, it was just, you can just picture this guy, like this stereotypical artist, you know, has a few smooth lines, speaks a little bit of French in this dark cafe. It is so cliche, but it's like, oh, we all have that one bad guy to some degree. Get it? Like, in your early 20s, you just don't know any better. Especially in the 50s, you don't know really. Women weren't taught to really assert themselves and know that it's okay to say no to guys, if you will. So, again, a great book. I think it's just, it's another wonderful read from a woman who lived her life, learned her lessons, is continuing to learn her lessons. She's not going to lie about that. You know, struggled and have struggles that a lot of you could relate to. I know I can relate to them. And yeah, it's just another woman's life. She just happened to be an actress who acted in The Nun Story with Audrey Hepburn. But it's her life, and she's going to tell you about it. So, again, The Men in My Life by Patricia Bosworth. So what's coming up next in my next book that I'm reading is I'm picking up again. I put it down for a little bit. Ida's Algorithm, another woman's story. I'm on this, like, wanting to read women's, like, memoirs and stories thing. I have not picked up a fiction book in so long. It's a little weird because usually I like fiction, but this is, like, my year of, like, nonfiction. I'll let you know how this goes. So, thank you so much. If you guys want to see me in real life, feel free to come to our Female Founders event. It is October 5th. Link is in the description below. I will see you guys all very soon. Again, like, share, subscribe. I love doing these videos for y'all.